إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم تسليمًا كثيرًا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالًا كثيرًا ونساءً، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله. Indeed, the most truthful speech is the book of Allah. وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. And the best guidance we have is the guidance of our beloved messenger Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. وشر الأمور محدثاتها. And the worst of affairs are those things when we invent into this religion of ours. وكل محدثة بدعة. And everything when we invent into this religion of ours is an innovation. وكل بدعة ضلالة. Every innovation is misguidance and it leads astray. وكل ضلالة في النار. And every going astray, every misguidance is in the hellfire. ثم أما بعد. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, فَلَمَّا بَلَغَ مَعَهُ السَّعَى قَالَ يَا بُنَيَّ إِنِّي أَرَى فِي الْمَنَامِ أَنْ أَذْبَحُكَ فَانْظُرْ مَاذَا تَرَى قَالَ يَا أَبَتِ افْعَلْ مَا تُؤْمَرْ سَتَجِدُنِي إِنْ شَاءَ اللَّهِ مِنَ الصَّابِرِينَ. Allah says in the Quran what means. And when his son, the son of Prophet Ibrahim, the son of Prophet Abraham, his son Ismail, when he was old enough to walk with him, the son he desired for himself to have his whole life, to have this son, to get to the age where he could walk with him, he said, "Oh my son, I have seen in a dream that I am to sacrifice you, to slaughter you, to sacrifice you to Allah. So tell me what you think." So Ismail alayhi salam didn't respond by saying, "You're crazy, man." He said, "Do as you are commanded, O my father." He addressed him with terms of respect, "O my father, do what Allah has commanded you to do. Insha'Allah, you will find me of the sabireen, of those who are patient." فَلَمَّا أَسْلَمَ وَتَلَّهُ الْجَبِينَ. And so, when they both had submitted themselves to the will of Allah, and he laid him prostrate on his forehead, or on the side of his forehead, ready for sacrifice. وَنَادَيْنَاهُ أَنْ يَا إِبْرَاهِيمُ. And we called out, "O Ibrahim, قَدْ صَدَّقْتَ الرُّؤْيَا. You have fulfilled the vision, you have fulfilled the dream. إِنَّ كَذَلِكَ نَجْزِ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. Verily do we reward the muhsineen, the good doers. إِنَّ هَذَا لَهُوَ الْبَلَاءُ الْمُبِينُ. This was indeed a manifest trial and a test for you. وَفَضَيْنَاهُ بِذِبْحٍ عَظِيمٍ. And we ransomed your son with a great ransom, a great sacrifice, a ram in place of his son. وَتَرَكْنَا عَلَيْهِ فِي الْآخَرِينَ. And we left for him a good remembrance for generations to come in later times. سَلَامٌ عَلَى إِبْرَاهِيمٍ. So peace be unto Ibrahim. كَذَلِكَ نَجْزِ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. Thus do we indeed reward the muhsinun, those doers of good. Look at the sacrifice on this day of sacrifice. The sacrifice of our father Ibrahim alayhi salam that he was going to make. And yearly we are reminded of this story and we commemorate it again and again by offering our own sacrifices to get closer to Allah. But what do we do this for? It is for me and for you and all of us to evaluate our sacrifice in this life. For our Lord, our Creator, our Sustainer, our Provider, the Bestower of Blessings, the one whose mercy we need and we are dependent on in order to enter Jannah. Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam, he left off his desires for the sake of obeying Allah and thus was rewarded by being elevated for generations to come in the eyes of the people. His name being mentioned as the father of the prophets, the establisher of Tawheed, the oneness of Allah with respect to his worship. evaluate this because it's all about the sacrifice. Look at the sacrifice he was about to make. And that is much greater than any sacrifice Allah has asked any of us to do. عن أبي قتادة رضي الله عنه عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال إنك لن تضع شيئا لله عز وجل. اسمعوا الكلام. إنك لن تضع شيئا لله عز وجل إلا بدلك الله به ما هو خير لك منه. This hadith, which is in the Muslim of Imam Ahmad and greatest Sahih, the Prophet ﷺ, he said, verily, you will never leave a thing for the sake of Allah. You will never leave anything because of the sake of Allah, the Almighty, but Allah will replace it with something better for you. Anything you leave, Allah will always give you what is better for it. And look at some other examples that highlight this. Prophet Yusuf alayhi salam, he was called by seduction to commit an immoral act by a beautiful, noble, wealthy woman. But he replied to Allah Azza wa Jal, or he called out to Allah, إِنَّ السِّدْنَ أَحَبُّ إِلَيَّ مِمَّا يَدْعُونَنِي إِلَيْهِ. Instead of responding to his desires, he said, oh Allah, prison is more dear to me than what they are calling me to. So because of this rejection of his desires, Allah the Glorified, he rewarded him for going to be confined in a little prison. He rewarded him by empowering him and giving him power over a great area, a great piece of land, and granted him full authority in the land. And the women who accused him of immorality, they also came out to free him of that accusation. He gave up something for Allah, even though it meant hardship for himself, and Allah gave him what was better. The Muhajirin, they had their homes in Mecca, their families in Mecca, their lives in Mecca, everything they owned in Mecca. But when the time came to leave it all for the sake of Allah, they left in a heartbeat. This is why Allah, he elevated the status of the Sahaba radiallahu anhum wa radahum. He said, وَالسَّابِقُونَ الْأَوَّلُونَ مِنَ الْمُهَاجِرِينَ وَالْأَنصَارُ وَالَّذِينَ اتَّبِعُوهُمْ بِإِحْسَانٍ رضي الله عنهم ورضوا عنه وأعد لهم جنات تجري من تحتها الأنهار خالدين فيها أبدا ذلك الفوز العظيم. Allah says what means, I'm the first to embrace Islam. The Muhajirin, those who left, they believed in the Prophet ﷺ and left everything they had behind so they could support the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And the Ansar, the citizens of Medina, who took them in and aided them, and those who followed them exactly in faith, Allah is well pleased with them, and they are well pleased with Him. He has prepared for them gardens under which rivers flow to dwell therein forever. This is the supreme success. They left their homelands, the most beloved things to them, and Allah gave them, Him being pleased with them. Allah gave them the promise that they will have gardens in paradise under which rivers flow forever. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the hadith from Abi Hurairah radiallahu anhu, he mentioned that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, سَبْعَةٌ يُذِلُّهُمُ اللَّهُ فِي ظِلِّهِ فِي يَوْمَ لَا ظِلَّ إِلَّا ظِلُّهُ. Seven who will be in the shade of Allah on a day where there's no shade except for the shade of Allah. يَوْمًا كَانَ مِقْدَارُهُ خَمْسِينَ أَلْفَ سَنَةٍ. The day which is 50,000 years long and the sun will be overhead like it is today. But it will be hot and people will be sweating out of fear to their ankles, some to the knees, some to the hips, some to their collarbones because of the fear of that day, but Allah will shade some of them. Listen to just two of those seven. رَجُلٌ دَعَتْهُ أَمْرَأَةٌ ذَاتَ مَنْصِبٍ وَجَمَالٍ وَقَالَ إِنِّي أَخَافَ اللَّهِ. A man who is being called to commit an immoral act, being seduced by another person, by a woman, and he says, instead of responding to his desires, he says, إِنِّي أَخَافَ اللَّهِ, I fear Allah. So he leaves off something for the sake of Allah, and Allah is going to give him shade on a day where there's no shade but Allah's shade. وَرَجُلٌ تَصَدَّقَ بِصَدَقَةٍ فَأَخْفَاهَا حَتَّى لَا تَعْلَمُ شِمَالُهُ مَا صَنَعَتْ يَمِينُهُ. And a man who gives in charity so secretly that his left hand doesn't know what his right hand has given. This is another person who Allah will shade on the day of resurrection. So you're giving wealth away that you have in this dunya only for Allah to give you better in this dunya and in the akhirah. Abu Umama, he narrated, he said, أَنَّ رَجُلًا سَأَلَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ مَا الْإِيمَانِ.
A man came to the Prophet ﷺ and said, what is Iman? فَقَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهِ وَسَلَّمْ إِذَا سَرَّتْكَ حَسَنَتُكَ وَسَاءَتْكَ سَيِّئَتُكَ فَأَنْتَ مُؤْمِنْ قَالَ يَا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ فَمَا الْإِثْمْ فَقَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهِ وَسَلَّمْ إِذَا حَاكَ فِي نَفْسِكَ شَيْءٌ فَدَعْهُ. This hadith, which is sahih in the Muslim Imam Ahmad, the Prophet ﷺ, when he was asked, what is faith? He replied to the man, if you're happy with your good deeds, when you do good for Allah, when you give in charity and you do something good, even if it tires you out, or you quote-unquote lose something in your material world, if you are happy with your good deeds and saddened by your bad deeds, that your bad deeds, you grasp yourself and you say, why did I commit this? Why do I do this? You're upset with yourself, remorseful, and that nadam, you have remorse and regret for what you did. He said, if you have this, you're a believer. The man asked him, O Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what is sin? And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, if something wavers in your soul, if something for the slightest bit makes you doubt, or it wavers in your mind or your soul, then you should leave it off. You should leave it and not fulfill it. My brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah, he said, إِن يَعْلَمُ اللَّهُ فِي قُلُوبِكُمْ خَيْرًا يُؤْتِكُمْ خَيْرًا مِمَّا أُخِذَ مِنْكُمْ وَيَغْفِرَ لَكُمْ وَاللَّهُ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he commanded the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to tell the captives who were in their hands, if Allah knows that there is good in your heart, he will give you something better than he has taken away from you. And he will forgive you, and Allah is all forgiving, most merciful. If you have goodness in your heart, and you regret when you disobey Allah or His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and you turn to Him in repentance, and you give up and you leave off what would anger Allah or what would disobey Him or His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah will give you better. Our Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam was asked to do the ultimate sacrifice, yet Allah has not asked us to do anything even closely comparable to such a great sacrifice. So look at your lives, look at your choices, compare what Allah is asking you. Ask yourself on this blessed day, is what Allah wants from me too much? Is He asking us to sacrifice the life of our loved ones? He ain't even asking us to do 1/100th of that. So when we commit to the sacrifice and leave something for the sake of Allah, know that Allah will give you something better. He will replace it with something better, and you must trust in His qadr, in His plan, in His decree. So when you leave off your culture because of your deen, because your deen comes before your culture, and you leave off shirk, you leave off associating partners with Allah, when you leave off bid'ah, when you leave off innovations, even at the expense of the anger of your family and people you love and care about, Allah will give you better support and aid you from where you could not imagine. وَمَنْ يَتَّقِ اللَّهِ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مَخْرَجًا. And whoever keeps their duty to Allah, Allah will give him or her a way out of every situation. When you leave off your sins, even the thoughts and the plans, the actions that make your soul waver, that give you any doubt, Allah will give you better, since you chose to protect your deen and your honor. Because the person who leaves off doubt, فَقَدْ اسْتَبْرَأَ لِدِينِهِ وَعِدِّهِ, Allah, He has protected His deen and His honor. When you leave off selling the haram, engaging in riba, doing anything which is wrong to gain wealth, and Allah, then Allah will give you something which is better, a rizq al-tayyib, the pure halal provisions. For the sisters, when you start wearing the hijab, even if it makes you hot, even if it makes you uncomfortable in front of the people, Allah will reward you and give you what is better, and He will give you patience and ease. For our brothers, when you leave off shaving your faces, and this is not a minor issue, this is an issue of importance, because it was a command, not an option given by the Prophet ﷺ. When you leave your beards, Allah will give you reward and bounty and true beauty. Aisha radiallahu anha, she said, Alhamdulillah, alladhi zayyana ar-rijalu bil-liha. Praise be to Allah. Gratitude and thanks and praise be to Allah who beautified men with their beards. So many of the men beautified in these first 10 days of the Hijjah, who offered sacrifice, refraining from removing the hair from their body. Do not go backwards. Allah will increase you in beauty and acceptance. Start coming to the masajid instead of praying at home. For he who safeguards the sunnah. Because this sunnah of praying in the masajid for the men is not an option. It's a command. They will earn Allah's pleasure and love. Give up your home for the masjid. Give up your comfort to pray in the masajid. And Allah will honor you as his guest. And then he will love you because you implemented the sunnah. قل إن كنتم تحبون الله فاتبعوني يحببكم الله ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم. Allah commanded the Prophet ﷺ to say, O Muhammad, indeed if you love Allah then follow me, meaning follow the Prophet ﷺ, follow his sunnah, then Allah will love you and forgive you for your sins. In conclusion, my brothers and sisters in Islam, if you have a job where you witness or see or deal in haram, leave it off and Allah will give you pure wealth. Leave off argumentation, especially with the family. Honor the family ties in the Silat al-Rahim. Keep the family ties, the ties of the womb. Keep your relationships so that Allah will not cut you off. Because he who cuts off his family, Allah will cut him or her off. And this is as the Prophet ﷺ said, you want to extend your lifespan and your wealth, then you maintain the family ties. Leave off disobeying your parents, making them upset at the expense of pleasing your desires or pleasing your friends. And you will find that Allah will give you true friends. And He Himself will be there to support and care for you. Leave off backbiting. Leave off slandering. Leave off jealousy and being envy of what other people have. Instead, make dua for your brothers and your sisters in Islam. And Allah will have the angels make dua for you. كما قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم في الحديث الصحيح. ما من عبد مسلم يدعو لأخيه بظهر الغيب إلا قال الملك ولك بمثل رواه مسلم. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, there is no believing servant who supplicates for his brother, makes dua for his brother or his sister in Islam behind their back, in their absence, that the angels but say for this one and the same be for you too. Leave off envy. Leave off desiring what the people have. Leave off jealousy, leave off backbiting and slandering. My brothers and sisters in Islam, the list of what we can leave off and the reward for it can go on and on. But the message is clear and straightforward. Whenever you give up something for Allah, whenever you give up something for Allah's pleasure to get closer to Him, whenever you sacrifice anything for Allah, for His sake, for His pleasure, He will give you what is better in this life, possibly, and for sure in the Akhirah. So on this day of sacrifice, let us begin to sacrifice and leave off what may anger or upset Allah, and rather go upon the path that would please Allah and allow us to earn His mercy. May Allah make us from those who leave off what is wrong and evil and immoral for His sake and to earn His pleasure and His mercy. Allahumma ighfir lil-muslimin wal-muslimat wal-mu'minin wal-mu'minat الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك أنت سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين وانصرنا على أعدائك وأعداء الدين اللهم انصر إخواننا وأخواتنا في فلسطين وفي كل مكان اللهم ثبت أقدامهم ويسر أمورهم وسهل أمورهم وارحم موتاهم واشف مرضاهم وتقبل شهداءهم يا ارحم الراحمين سبحان ربك رب العزه عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى اله وصحبه اجمعين تقبل الله منا ومنكم وعيدكم مبارك may Allah accept from you and from us عيد مبارك اختارنا مبارك شاء to all of our beautiful community to all of the beautiful children Have a blessed day. This Eid is 4 days. Today, Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday. Ayyam, Ta'am, and Rashurbin, wa dhikrillah. Days of eating and drinking and remembering Allah. Have a great Eid, and may Allah bless you and your families. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.